to our Hispanic Heritage Month. It's going to be our staff interview today. So we're going to be asking you a couple of questions about your background, okay? So we're going to begin with, what is your name and what is your role at the school, Mr. Bonilla?
My name is Ms. Bonilla, and I am a sixth grade science.
And I'm Ms. Merkel, and I'm currently teaching seventh grade math, and soon I'll be teaching RTI for math for middle school.
Very good, thank you. Okay, first question, where were you born?
I was born in Bronx, New York.
Okay, I'm Ms. Merkel.
And I was born in the Canary Islands, Spain.
Very good, oh my God. Okay, what is your family's country of origin?
So both of my parents were born in Dominican Republic. My mom is from Santiago, my dad from San Francisco.
Hi, Ms. Merkel.
My whole family is from the same island, Tenerife, and my parents and my sisters and I are from Santa Cruz, from the capital.
You know what? I put into this. My parents too from the Canary Islands, so yep. We all have a Hispanic background.
And right? I was raised in Venezuela, and she was born in Venezuela. So
look at that. Okay, how long have you lived in the United States?
My whole life, 26 years.
26 years. I came as an exchange student in 82 for 1 year, and then I came back in 91 when I got married. And I've been here since.
All right, okay, very good. Okay, have you always known English or Spanish, or how did you learn?
So, my first language is actually Spanish. My mom made sure that also involved my, it was really hard on my dad for it. I was actually learning English in school when I first started going to preschool.
Okay, so yes. You were an ESOL student.
I was an ESOL boy.
All right. Ms. Merkel.
Well, obviously Spanish, and then they teach you English at school, the very basics. And then when I was an exchange student is when I finally got some kind of immersion in the language. I lived with a family in North Carolina for a year. Nobody spoke any Spanish, so. And I graduated from high school, and all my classes were in English. But then I didn't speak any English for 8 years, and then I got married, and so it took a while to for everything to come back, and I'm still learning.
All right, we all are. Okay, so how has your family or your family's life changed since you moved to the U.S., or since they moved to the U.S.?
Well, my family, they definitely weren't welcome. So they came to the States, like I think every immigrant's dream and goal to come to the States is to have a better life. So my parents moved from DR, moved up to New York. My parents definitely weren't rich, but I think they definitely had a lot more resources than they were able to accomplish. What they wanted was for them to have a better life and for their future children, which eventually I came about. For us, I have a better life, but now I'm here. I have a college degree now. I'm working at a school as a teacher, things that possibly wouldn't have been possible if we were still in DR. My parents stayed in DR. So.
We'll be completely different, right? Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
All right. And you, Ms.
Marco? For me, a complete 180 degrees. When I came here, my ex-husband was a Marine, so I lived in a military base for a while, and that was a big difference compared to growing up in Venezuela. And then I went back to college, and so that was something else that was different. The university life and style here is very different from what I was used to.
What is a Hispanic tradition that you wish to pass down and that your parents have passed down to you?
Oh, absolutely. I'm gonna give you two perfect examples. So one of our main historic dishes is called mantou. So it's the Dominican version of mashed potatoes, except we use plantains. So we basically make a mashed potato out of plantains, and it comes with salami frito, queso, huevo. just greatness. It's so good. And then I have a 6-year-old son, so I want him to have some dance moves. So Dominicans dance bachata, so I would definitely love my son to be a bachatero.
Well, growing up in Venezuela, they believe in Santa. And I was coming from the island where we believe in the three kings, the wise men. So I thought that was important to teach it to my children. So every year we do both. We do our Christmas, our Santa thing, and then in January we still do the Three Kings, and we put the shoe, the slipper by the sofa, and all that. I try to keep that tradition alive so they learn a little bit about where we're from. Religion. A lot of the religion traditions, like when I took them to the Canary Islands for the first time, I showed them around all the churches and taught them a lot of things that they didn't know about. Food, they already love paella like I do, so that's good. And then music, my daughter's really good at dancing salsa. That's what
and
I learned in Venezuela.
Teaches her moves.
Exactly, so I learned that in Venezuela, not in Spain, but she can dance salsa. And then I'm trying to, my father was really big in music from the Canary Islands, so I always try to keep that alive so they...
What do you think are the contributions that Hispanics have made to the U.S.?
I think for sure the workforce, they made such an impact on the workforce and just establishing the nation for where it is today. But I think things with music, things with sports, I think Hispanics dominate baseball. I think we're dominating that sport.
I was gonna say the same thing. I think all the different cultures that you find in this country make American culture richer in every sense. So everything that he said, he talks about baseball because he's from the Dominican Republic. I would say soccer wasn't a big deal here years ago, and now it's very
Absolutely.
Popular. And you see, my uncle was a professional player in Spain, so that's my sport.
Yes.
And I'm so happy to see that even women here got inspired by that. And you see, we don't have women playing soccer, and now American women play soccer. So, and even culturally, I think, look around you, how many teachers are from other countries in this country, and no matter what, they bring part of their culture to the classroom, and the kids get a richer education because of it. And definitely music, you know, like what America doesn't listen to Marc Anthony, right? So, and everybody tries to dance a little salsa and all that, so, you know.
Yeah, definitely the contributions that go beyond.
And the food. My kids eat Venezuelan food too, and Spanish food too, so in every corner, so yeah.
Okay, so the last question would be, what would be a phrase or saying that reminds you of your country?
Well, for us, chévere. You know, like chévere is like awesome, so everything is chévere.
All right, thank you very much.